In this video, I'll be going through three key takeaways from a recent study on the portfolio diet that analyzed data from over 200,000 participants over a 30-year period. To my knowledge, this is the first large-scale study investigating how adherence to the portfolio diet in free-living people is associated with the risk of suffering from a heart attack or stroke. Hi, I'm Chong, a qualified nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. The study that I'm focusing on today was published in late 2023 and examined how adherence to the portfolio diet could lower cardiovascular disease or CVD risk by analyzing data from more than 200,000 participants collected over a 30-year period. I'll be discussing three main takeaways from the study, but I'll first like to describe the data that was used for the analysis. The participants in this study were all healthcare professionals, with about three quarters being women from the first two nurses' health studies, and one quarter being men from the health professionals' follow-up study. The two nurses' health studies and the health professionals' follow-up study are all large-scale studies started in the 1970s and 1980s, and are still ongoing. What is amazing about these studies is that participants are requested to fill out a detailed questionnaire every 2 years on various aspects of their lifestyle and health conditions. They are also asked to complete a diet questionnaire every 4 years, as well as provide blood and urine samples about once every 10 years. What is even more amazing is the dedication of the participants in responding to the requests to fill in follow-up questionnaires, with a response rate of around 90%. What that means is that the studies have generated an incredible amount of data that has produced many important findings, including one of the earliest links between smoking and poor health outcomes. With that out of the way, what were the results from this update to the portfolio diet? The results were quite striking, and I'll summarize them with the following three main takeaways. I'll also be throwing in a bit of bonus content, so do watch till the end. But before that, if you're enjoying this video, do help me by hitting the subscribe and the like buttons and turn on the notifications. You could also check out this other video where I discuss the randomized controlled trials performed on the portfolio diet, and I'll drop the link for that video in the description below as well. Number one, the study found that greater adherence to the portfolio diet was associated with a 14% lower risk of cardiovascular disease, defined primarily as having a heart attack or stroke. In fact, the results mirrored the dose-response trends demonstrated by the earlier randomized controlled trials with respect to LDL cholesterol. That is, the more one adhered to the portfolio diet, the greater the reduction in risk of getting a heart attack or stroke. Number two, as the data was collected from participants who were simply going about their everyday life, the participants in the study with the greatest adherence to the portfolio diet were actually eating amounts of portfolio foods that were still lower than the recommended amounts compared to the randomized controlled trials. And as such, to achieve the level similar to the group of participants with the highest intake of portfolio foods in the study, one could consume each day, and I quote, 1/2 cup of beans or 1 cup of soy milk, 1 cup of cooked oatmeal, 1/2 cup of eggplant, 0.5 to 1 ounce of nuts, and 1 tablespoon of olive oil. And the researchers recommend that this be done to replace foods that are higher in saturated fat and cholesterol. In other words, to potentially achieve the 14% reduction in CVD risk, the amounts of portfolio foods to be eaten each day are actually very achievable. Number three, you might have noticed that the researchers mentioned foods like beans, eggplant, and olive oil, which do not seem to be on the list of portfolio foods from my earlier videos. In the randomized controlled trials, viscous fiber from oats, barley, and psyllium were highlighted, but in fact, there are other foods, including eggplant, that contain various kinds of viscous fiber. Soy protein was emphasized in the randomized controlled trials, but all plant proteins, especially from legumes, are also encouraged as meat substitutes as part of the portfolio diet. And finally, in 2010, the researchers performed a randomized controlled trial to confirm the positive heart-healthy effects of monounsaturated fats and added healthy plant oils such as olive oil as a component of the portfolio diet. What this means is that the portfolio diet is actually quite expensive and contains many more foods that are readily available and consumed in Asian cooking. Before I go into the bonus content, I just want to mention that I'll be making separate videos on the research that has been done on some of these other types of portfolio foods and their impact on CVD risk. So hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications so that you don't miss out on those videos. And if you know a loved one who might have CVD issues, share this video and see if it helps them. As a bit of bonus content, if you're trying to increase the amount of viscous fiber in your diet, you could add the following items to your shopping cart. These would include vegetables like okra and eggplant, and fruits like apples and oranges. Okra and eggplant are widely available in this region, so add them onto your taipeng or economy rice when you have lunch. And apples and oranges, which are what I like to call oldies but goodies, are great sources of a kind of viscous fiber called pectin. So increase the amount of viscous fiber in your overnight oats by throwing in some of these fruits as well. In the meantime, check out a couple of these other videos related to heart health, and I'll see you next time.